Abstract brainwaves, game genie in the beanie. We ain't on the same stage, leveled up. The epitome of technique, can't survive in my current thought.
Other yellow hat guy here, back with another video. And what's up, boys and girls? How's it going? Well, Pokemon Go has evolved. See what I did there? You can remote raid. We've discussed that. I've showcased that. They've given you a lot of opportunity to still play the game by getting balls and berries and things like that that you need to keep catching Pokemon, right? If you can't get out because you're stay-at-home order or state restriction or country restriction, whatever your situation is, how can you continue playing Pokemon Go? Well, I mean, the critters are just right near the house now. Cool. But what if you just need more? Currently, even though you can remote raid, you cannot spin the gym. You cannot remote battle the gym either. It's just raiding. So what am I getting at here? While you have a free pass every day and those remote passes, none of those bring you coins. They just take away coins. Matter of fact, you're spending your money to continue doing this when a lot of us in the heyday of Pokemon Go, we were in 10 gyms a day, collected 100 coins a week, and used that to, you know, spend on lucky eggs or whatever, balls, whatever you needed. Now with it only being 50 coins that you can earn a day, a lot of people still continue to do the gyms, but not competitively. It's like, oh, here's one I can fit. Boom, I'm in there. Because, you know, you used to be able to have, I think, 10 Pokemon in a gym. Now it's just only 6. So that's disheartening too. Maybe they could increase the gym cap. You know what I'm saying? While, you know, no one's going to sit at a parking lot and attack to do, you know, a gym battle. I mean, you've got the other half of the mechanic there. People would, you know, trick the game cheatingly. Mind you, cheatingly. They would be cheating and trick the game into thinking they're in one location or another. I'm not going to get into all that. You guys already don't like when I talk about that. And I'm not trying to have that argument either. But the reality is, with the remote raid passes, part of that gameplay that they didn't want you to really do, they made adjustments for. They were accommodating because you can't expect people to get out. The other part of that is, hey, how can I take over a gym? I don't know if that's going to change, but the coin system has got to. Now, why am I even talking cryptic like this? Well, it's because they did. At least they're announcing it. Here it is right here, PokemonGoLive.com. And let me grab this while I have the opportunity to. Here we go. We'll be running small tests for revamping the PokeCoin system. Trainers, right now the only way to earn PokeCoins is to defend gyms. But since Pokemon Go's release, we've added features that have vastly changed the way you play. Right? They have. In addition, with more trainers playing at home, we're looking to provide more ways for you to earn Pokecoins while playing in one place. So in the future, we'll be rewarding you with Pokecoins for activities besides defending gyms. Slow clap. We'll soon be testing this update only with trainers in Australia, and it'll be coming to all trainers after this testing phase. In order to balance this new method of earning coins, or earning Pokecoins, the number of Pokecoins earned from defending gyms will be reduced from 6 per hour to 2. The maximum number of Pokecoins you can earn in a day will be increased to 55. So there's a caveat there, right? You lose the gym side of it, but you can gain others probably by doing certain tasks. We're about to read up. Here are some daily activities you might see. Complete the featured activities each day to receive 5 Pokecoins. Make an excellent throw. Evolve a Pokemon. make a great throw, use a berry to help catch a Pokemon, take a snapshot of your buddy, catch a Pokemon, power up a Pokemon, make a nice throw, transfer a Pokemon, win it raid. During the initial rollout in Australia, we'll continue to collect feedback and perform additional testing based on the results. Thank you for your continued support, and we look forward to providing this update to all trainers once testing is complete. Please stay tuned to official channels for updates. Please be aware of your surroundings and follow guidelines from local health and authorities when playing Pokemon Go. Upcoming events are subject to change. Be sure to follow us on social media. Opt in. Yeah, I'm not even reading the rest of that because you either already do that or you don't. So that's straight from, you know, the source right there. But as we go into the game, there's additional stuff going on right now, which I think should warrant coins, but, you know, that's going to be what it's going to be. So I'm not going to put a graphic up of this. It's just what we've got going on right now that I wanted to speak to. And that's this weekend. So I'm not sure when I plan on having this video up. Hopefully as soon as possible. But first and foremost, Go Battle League Season 2 begins Monday. It was delayed. I think it was supposed to start earlier in the month of May. It's not happening. But here we go. We had a spotlight hour the other day, and Shellder was everywhere. Now, Darkrai is out of its season, or it's gone for that week that it was in, and now we've got the Origin Form Giratina. Kind of over that Pokemon, but, I mean, what else am I going to do? More Animal Crossing, right? Giratina's here for the week. The Kanto research, there wasn't really anything too eventful for me to show you guys. I mean, I got the Mewtwo. I think I did that in maybe a day and a half. It really didn't take much work at all, and I'm not complaining. I really don't need a whole lot of effort with stuff going on here. So those throwback challenges will continue. Next up, May 8th, Friday, we've got the Johto timed events. So I will be looking forward to that. So if that's starting Friday, we've also got this Snubbull stuff going on. Yes, Snubbull. So I will screen grab this to show. Look forward to Snubbull limited research and Incense Day, water and dark type. In May, you can look forward to events you can participate in right from the comfort of your home. Snubbull limited research on Saturday, May 29th from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. local time, so pretty much all day. You can enjoy Snubbull limited research through special time research tasks. Incense Day, water and dark type on Sunday, May 17th from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. local time. You can enjoy an Incense Day featuring water-type Pokemon and dark-type Pokemon, notably Carvana. You might even encounter a shiny Carvana if you're lucky. So there's that. So pretty much almost a week there as well. You're having stuff go on. So, you know, Snubbull is right after what's going on Friday. So today, Wednesday, raid hour. Friday, you've got that research going on, or not that research, excuse me. What did I say was there? Something starts Friday. I'm on video and forgot that quick, right? Obviously, it's the throwback. There's just so many of the throwbacks, it's easy to say which throwback it is, right? It's every week, every Friday, so I'm leaving that in. I'm not editing it out, by the way. That throwback is there. So what am I really trying to allude to? How congested everything is. Again, not a complaint, not a knock. It says Friday you've got what's going on. Saturday you've got what's going on with the Snubbull. And then Sunday, the Safari Zone. Safari Zone is there. So with the Safari Zone being there, it's just going to be crazy what they have there. And there's really no way for me to look in here to talk about that, because I'm pretty sure it wasn't clear in the notifications that that's what's happening. I mean, we'll go into the events real quick. And, yep, there you go. Safari Zone was in, here, let's accept that, because that's really in the way. In those other cities, UK, but we've got the Philadelphia one on the 8th till the 10th. So that's the whole weekend there, and then Monday that Battle League returns. So they've got everything lined up, and it's Mother's Day. It's Mother's Day, yes. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Earthbound Day. Happy whatever. Jokes aside, I will try to show some of that. I've got something interesting, interesting opportunity presented itself my way. So I will look forward to trying to share that with you guys when I can, if I can. That said, the Shelter event, if you can call it event, it felt like an event because there were so many shelters. I mean, if you just look at this, they were everywhere. I went to do a raid and couldn't escape them. I had seen a picture online of a friend showing all the shelters in their location. I was like, eh, maybe it's because it's supposed to be rainy weather that they're boosted like that. And granted, we don't live too far apart. There was a mob of them, as you can see in this footage up here. I mean, just the disappointing part of it and why I don't have more footage is for the simple fact that, well, I clicked on like 20 of those things and not one was shiny. Like, for real, not one was shiny. Oh my gosh. And I'm just looking at everybody else just like, first one I tapped on at the house. Niantic is really trying me with that. Granted, I could have used one of my alternate accounts and possibly got one because, you know, again, they want the newer accounts to sit in there and say, hey, remember that excitement of getting a shiny? While the rest of us are bitter. Why do you get the shiny? Well, I should get it because I've been playing forever. I've been supporting you guys forever. So you thank me for the support in here, but you don't really show it. You don't really show it, Niantic. Got a bias there that you need to, you know, maybe, here's an idea. How about a badge that says, hey, you played the game from day one? Something like that. Maybe it's already there and I don't notice it because nobody really looks at badges, but you don't really give an incentive to care. When can I display my badge on my avatar? Why isn't it there on the friends list? When I look at my friends list, there should be badges there showing, hey, you know, maybe I've won X amount of battles in Battle League. Something other than, hey, I just caught a Zubat 5 minutes ago. You gotta step that up, Niantic. And I know you guys watch these videos despite what the view count looks like on my channel. So thank you for that, but consider all that. And I think you are. I think it's just you got a hierarchy of needs list or what wants. And you guys are doing your darndest to keep this game alive. I mean, I always say every year, like, I'm still playing Pokemon Go. I mean, I said it so much that I had to start making videos about it because it's been integral to, you know, a part of my time on this earth. Part of my energy, my being has been put into, you know, this game, giving back to my city, connecting with people, making friends, all that stuff that I always talk to you guys about. So that said, I'm not going to preach too much. I'm going to end this one here. Nothing eventful on the screen right now. So we're just going to wrap this up. I will see you very soon. Captain Sensation.